Hi everyone, welcome back to the podcast. Happy Sunday morning. I hope you're doing well. Hope yesterday night revelries have not tired you out too much and you're not recovering from a hangover or a headache, and I hope you're feeling better. Today is Sunday. It's time to recharge, regroup, refocus on the week ahead. So I thought I'll just quickly talk about Andrew Huberman's morning routine, something similar which I do, which I think is important. So why are morning routines important for entrepreneurs and investors? Routines help you improve your productivity. Productivity enhances productivity. Important thing about routines is it helps you starting the day in a structured routine that prioritizes your mental and physical well-being and can significantly help you focus on what you need to do for the day and stop your mind from wandering off. This is why I say it's important to have a morning routine. This is going to be my routine, which I'm going to talk about. You can do something similar, or you maybe already have a routine and you should maybe think about adding a few things and changing these few things if you feel inspired by what I'm saying. Second thing why I say have a morning routine is it reduces stress. It reduces anxiety. All of us have very busy lives nowadays with social media and all kinds of distractions. So stress and anxiety levels are way high. And having a morning routine helps you just start off your day without having to wonder what you need to do. Should I do this first? Should I do that first? It kind of gets you out of your mental stupor. It kind of weakens your consciousness, gets you into a habit of, okay, I must do this and do this. And it's a pattern which you follow and gets this whole process of thinking out of the way. So gets your day running. You hit your day running. Third thing that follows up with this is it improves your focus. The hardest thing all of us find nowadays, as I was saying before, was focus. Yes, reduction of anxiety and stress. What it improves is it's our focus. Anxiety and the stress are the Achilles heels of focus. If you're feeling very stressed out and very anxious, it is very hard to focus, because as you try to draw your mind into a task which you need to do or something you need to pay attention to, especially if it's a physical task, your mind can start wandering and accidents can happen. So it's important to have a routine to help you lower your stress and improve your focus. Another thing morning routines help you is it learns you to optimize your decision making. Sometimes the right decision may be not be the one which you want, but you have to choose one which is the most optimum. Manmohan Singh famously told this to my brother. Yes, I would have liked to do many things when I was Prime Minister, but unfortunately, with the coalition government, I had to do what was optimum. What I could do best, I did. So that is what is the essence of this. It's not what is the best thing to do, it is what is the optimum thing to do. And when you have a morning routine, you realize this, that sometimes you cannot do your best, sometimes you cannot do what you want, but you get something close to that. And you learn to work with that and move forward. Another thing a morning routine helps you to engage is in adaptability. It keeps you nimble. It keeps you able to adjust with whatever the day throws at you, because you're in this heightened state of awareness because of all the things you've done leading up to starting your day. And it gets you to be agile, as they say, in the industry. And it's a key thing to having long-term success and mental resilience. Mental resilience is your mind, no matter what sudden curveballs life may throw at you, a morning routine helps you build this mental resilience and ensures that you have long-term success. So as a value investor, as an entrepreneur, that is the most crucial thing which you want. You want to have long-term success. Short-term gains are absolutely useless if you are an entrepreneur or a value investor. We work towards having long-term success. We want long-term growth. We want steady, reliable, long-term growth. So these are the kind of things which I want you to keep in mind as I talk about my morning routine, what I do, maybe something you can do, and something maybe, like I said, will inspire you to add in or take or change or look at your morning routine differently. There are five crucial dimensions to a morning routine, which I tell you about, which is one is work, the other is the body, the mind, the breath, and the soul. This is not a spiritual thing, so don't mistake me. I'm not here to profess about any religion or any god, or I'm not trying to sell you any wonder drug. This is, soul is something innately all of us human feel. It's an individual personal experience. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about, and I don't want to get deep dive into that and make this into one philosophical or, you know, a religious endeavor. It is not. This is a purely practical, real, reality-driven morning routine. Okay. Most important, before you do your morning routine, is make sure you prioritize sleep. Sleep is very, very critical. And there's no rule like you must have 8 hours of sleep, 7 hours of sleep, 6 hours of sleep. Sleep is sleep. Each of our bodies are different. Like how each of us are taller, shorter, wider, thinner. So same way, you have a set pattern of sleep which your body requires. And your body knows this and you know this. So make sure you get that sleep. Your sleep may be, you know, 3-4 hours of sleep for some people. Like Rock Dwayne Johnson does this. He sleeps 4-5 hours a day and that's enough for him. Some of us need more sleep, 7 hours of sleep, but make it a priority. Whatever the amount of sleep that makes you feel rested and recharged in the morning is the amount of sleep you need. So focus on that. And it's important that you do this, because if you don't do this, that's just prioritizing your sleep and having a good night's rest, you're going to wake up in the morning and no matter what routine you do, whatever you try and do with caffeine and whatever, it's not going to get you going. If anything, it's only going to stumble you and fumble you as you try and get your day going. So, prioritize sleep. Second, which is step number one, invigorating the body and the heart. So, a bit of hydration. Drink some water. I do this. I drink almost 850 ml to a liter of water in the morning. You can drink it cold. You can drink it warm. I drink it cold because I live in Chennai. I don't know where you live. So, depending on where you are, maybe it can be cold or warm. Cold water works for me. But hydration is important. Your body's been sleeping. So a bit of hydration gets your body going. And exercise. This exercise can be anything. It can be simple, something like as yoga, stretching, a walk, a jog. Whatever you feel is your exercise, your routine. Doesn't have to be profound. You don't have to go and immediately start lifting weights. You don't have to, you know, get into calisthenics or anything crazy. I'm not telling you to do that. Something to get your body going, because once the blood starts moving, the heart starts pumping, you generally start waking up. So those are two things. First thing, drink water, then do some kind of exercise. This works for me and I want you to try it if you have not tried it, which is cold showers. Cold shower has many benefits. This is physiological benefits, which have doctors themselves have said and recognized. It stimulates your nervous system and stimulates your heart nerves. So it's something wonderful to try if you've never tried it before, is have a cold shower. If you especially want to wake up in the morning, like my cameraman Karthi behind is yawning and he's feeling sleepy, he wouldn't have had a cold shower today. If you had a nice cold shower in the morning instead of a hot shower, he would be feeling a lot more invigorated and awake. So cold shower helps. Try it if you've never tried it before. The third step which I wanted to do is creating awareness. And for me, awareness is created by doing meditation and doing breath work. Again, this is not tied to religion. I'm not asking you to chant some holy mantram. I'm not asking you to believe in some god. I'm not trying to tell you this or that. Meditation is just nothing but listening to your mind. It's as simple as that. Your brain, like how your heart beats, how your blood flows, your brain as an organ is constantly generating thought. And this thought is your background white noise. And through your day, it's telling you things and constantly feeding you information. So spending a little time to create awareness, to realize the noise from the information is important. Not every single thought your brain generates is of value. It is okay to recognize your brain generates thoughts because it's meant to. Don't judge these thoughts. Don't value these thoughts. Take what you need from it. Like walking through a shopping aisle, when you go to a supermarket, you take the products you need and you move on. If you don't know what you're writing, you don't like a list into your shopping market and you walk into the shopping market, trust me, you'll end up with a cart full of things you did not intend to buy and nor do you need. Most of it will be unhealthy. The same is true with your mind. If you do not go to your mind and take the thoughts which you need and segregate what you want and leave the rest behind, you'll end up full of cart full of thoughts which do not do anything for you other than slowing you down. So keep this in mind. This is why I say meditation and breath work is important and essential. It helps you focus and clarify your mind to the point where you know what you want and you focus on that. That's step three. Step four. This is the easiest step of all of them. And none of you guys do this, including my cameraman Karthi. I'm sure does not do this. He doesn't even know what I'm talking about right now. When I say step four, it's called journaling. I've repeatedly said this on many videos that even a lot of you who admire Rock, the Dwayne Johnson, how his success is, he journals. What is journaling? Journaling is planning the day's task and streamlining it in a 2-minute process. So you just write down. If you want to extend yourself like what I do, you can write about what you did previous day, what you plan to do today. And I actually, end of the day, I read my journal. If you do that, wonderful. You can try it. It's something wonderful. Otherwise, something new to you and you really don't want to get into it too much, is simply taking a book, opening the sheet and saying, putting today's date down and saying, okay, today I have to do A, B, C, D, E, F, and listing it all down. So you kind of streamline your mind and streamline your day, and you have a clear plan of action of saying, okay, I need to do all this today. So that's important. And why is this important to list out? The reason why is it leads to step 5. Step 5 is known as eating the frog. Eating the frog is tackling the most challenging tasks of the day early. This will increase your productivity. We say this in all exams. We advise this to children. We'll tell them, first, when you get your question paper in the exam hall, read all the questions. Don't do anything. First, read the question paper from the front to the back. It's not going to take you more than a couple of minutes to read all the questions. Then you'll know what all the questions are there. You'll know what all ones you find the hardest questions to answer, which questions you find the easiest to answer. And the trick is to do the hard ones first, because that will consume the most amount of time in your examination. Because the easy ones, you'll do it fast. Don't waste time doing the easy ones first. Do the hard ones first. So then as you finish off the time, you'll have ample time left over to finish the easy ones at the end. Same way with the task. When you have made your list of tasks, do the hard ones first. Then jump into doing the easy ones. This way you'll build momentum. And it's like running down a hill. You'll pick up velocity and you'll be able to finish all your tasks. If you keep the last ones to the end of the day, it's like climbing a mountain. Each step gets harder and harder, taking more and more mental and physical energy. By the time you reach the top and it's the end of the day, you feel quite taxed and finished. But if you do it in reverse, by end of the day, you'll actually feel quite light and fresh. So these are the 5 things I want you to keep in mind. One is prioritize sleep. Get your day going with some water and a bit of exercise. Have a cold shower after that, so you kind of like jolt your mind awake. Do a bit of meditation, breath work. Doesn't have to be long. You don't want to spend the entire 1 hour, 2 hours doing it. If you like it, do it. I'm not against it. It's great if you can do this kind of dedicated time. Most of us are busy, especially entrepreneurs and investors. So a bit of it. 5 minutes is good. 2 minutes is good. Even a minute. If that's all you can do, a minute of meditation, sit and do it. Taking 4 breaths, holding it, releasing it for a minute, gets the job done. It's as simple as that. It's a habit. Remember, you're building on this. Then, after the meditation, step 3, journal, which is writing what all you have to do for the day, so you know what needs to be done. And number 5, do the hardest ones first, then get in the easier ones. So this is what I do. This is how my day starts. And my day starts, you don't have to wake up early. Some of you read about this thing, I ever get up at 5. I get up at 5:30 every day. Of course, my life requires me to be up at 5:30. Before, when I was not married and wasn't a father, I used to wake up at 7. So this waking up at 5, it's a personal choice. For me, the reason why I wake up at 5:30, 5 in the morning is it gets me a bit of time, silence in my house before my kids wake up and before my household wakes up. Gives me a little bit of time to gather my thoughts. That's important for me. If you're a bachelor, like Kesav is, maybe 6:30 is enough for you. So pick a time. You don't have to do it the times which I do it at. Thing is to make sure you pick a routine which you can stick to, which you can follow, which you can work with. And like I said in the beginning of the video, this enhances your productivity, it reduces your stress, improves your focus and overall energy, and improves your decision making and creates mental resilience, and it all fosters personal growth. So these are the things I want to talk about today on a Sunday morning. I know I do have this habit of talking really fast, especially when I get into the flow of things, I tend to pick up speed. So I will try and slow this down so more of you can follow what I'm saying. But I do feel that you would have got the essence of what I'm saying. And if you do like this kind of things, there are many of these kind of videos. Andrew Huberman's video is very famous. His routine is followed by a lot of people. You can check out his. Mine is quite inspired by what he was saying in his video. So I strongly ask you guys to check out these kind of videos, something to help you motivate and stay focused. That being said, see you on the Monday morning as we start the week tomorrow. I hope all of you will enjoy your Sunday and Sunday brunches and lunches, and see you in the next one. Bye.